Come, come close, listen carefully. There is on this night good news to tell.
A story like none other, a story both ancient and new.
It is a wonder.
A joyous expectancy.
So come, come to the night of stars and angels and glorias.
This night of shepherds and miracles and kings.
The great maker of promises has spoken, and from his heart a child comes.
A savior born for us, promised Messiah, God's word in flesh.
And he brings with him these gifts.
Redemption, forgiveness, hope.
We have waited for so long.
Now the fullness of time is upon us.
The longing complete.
And the great chasm between God and us has a bridge, a baby.
Come and worship him.
Lay gifts at his feet.
Your life, your heart, your praise.
Come ye faithful, come.
Let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Mountains before earth, from everlasting
eternal footsteps, full of mercy and love, full of grace and truth, entered our world, and stepping forth from of old, he came.
Surely the Lord God does nothing unless he reveals his secret to his servants, the prophets.
But you, Bethlehem, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be ruler of Israel.
Mountains grand.
through the prophets, the stage was set for God to be orchestrated the coming of his son. Now, the same meticulous timing that he revealed in the creation of the world is seen in the miracle of the incarnation.
The waiting for the coming Messiah continued for centuries. Generations passed before the promise was fulfilled.
Now, suddenly, it was the fullness of time.
And on this quiet night, forever to be remembered as a holy night, in the rolling hills of Judea, just outside the tiny village of Bethlehem, God spoke through a host of angels. The message they brought changed the world forever.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David the Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Just as quickly as the angels appeared, they were gone. The frightened shepherds stared at the sky in disbelief. God was coming. God was coming, and he was coming tonight.
The storm that just happened in the heavens now lit a fire under their feet. With angel voices ringing in their ears, they ran. They ran through the hills and across the streets, straight into the little town.
Breathlessly, they arrived at the manger, and in stunned silence, they entered.
To the babe so dear.
quiet solitude of the stable was only temporary for the Holy Family.
Heavenly echoes were still lingering in the air when the shepherds came running through that tiny village. Eventually, the good news would be shared with the whole world.
For those that have ears to hear, the voice of the prophet speaks to us from ages past. Unto you a child is born, unto you a son is given.
Wondering. At last he was here. Nothing could have prepared Mary for the rush of love she felt when she looked at her baby. She whispered his name, the very name the angel had proclaimed to her, Jesus. It was
Joseph, come and see your child. Won't you cradle him a while? Can you see the Father in the Son? Come touch the face of the Holy One. He is here, that's all I know. Now we can love and walk. Joseph, come and see your child.
Thank you.
narrative of the Christmas story provided for us in Scripture offers little information about the wise men.
We know they came from a great distance, a new star in the heavens guiding them.
We know that Herod did not deceive them, and that they brought with them priceless treasure.
When they finally had their audience with the child king, they presented their gifts. Then they bowed down and worshiped him.
Gifts of great significance, gold, frankincense, and myrrh were laid at the feet of the Christ child. These were gifts that could only come from royal treasures. The gifts we bring are of such much greater value to the Lord of my life, my heart, my praise, all of my desires, all of my accomplishments, all of my failures, all of the thanksgiving I can comprehend. All of me, the surrender of my imagined authority to the author of all life, the giver of every good and perfect gift, Jesus, Messiah.
The Savior born this day, the Prince of Heaven enthroned upon this hay. The treasures that are holding I lay before my King. and humbly I bow. Three gifts to you I bring. My life surrendered, my heart now tender, my praise and offering, Lord, to you I bring. My life committed, my heart submitted, my praise and offering, Lord, hear me as I sing. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Father, I give out of all you've given me your only Son, to set my spirit free. A new heart is mine, and a new song to sing, and humbly I bow. Three gifts to you I praise and offering, Lord, to you I bring. My life committed, my heart submitted, my praise and offering, Lord, hear me as I sing. Glory, Gloria, Gloria, sing Gloria, oh Gloria, we sing Gloria, Gloria, Gloria.
Lord, the gift you gave is beyond our ability to comprehend. You gave yourself. You came, and in your coming, you brought to us forgiveness, redemption, and hope. in light of such gifts, what can we offer you in return? We dare not offer worthless gifts, talents, or wealth. We come to you imperfect and broken, and we offer this: our lives laid down, our hearts surrendered, all of our worship. It's all we have. It's all you ask. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Story ancient becomes the story new. Redeeming love has come, a Savior born for us.
This holy season, we remember the greatest gift, the gift that cannot be bought, transferred, or earned, that cannot be taken. It can only be received.
This gift is beyond our comprehension, but not beyond the giver's compassion.
For the Word became flesh and moved right into the neighborhood. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only God Emmanuel. God with us.
Oh, Thank you for coming this evening. On behalf of the staff, elders, and of Community Presbyterian Church, we thank you for joining us for this worship experience. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you the executive director of the Community Hope Center, Mary. Is she here? She was, oh, right here. Okay. She has a word. And then we have one more song.
Well, I want to thank each one of you for bringing your offering of diapers and boots with us. You know, anytime a new mom walks into the Community Hope Center and she's got that little baby there, I can't help but think about Mary and Joseph going door to door asking, is there room for me? Is there room? And then thinking about when Mary was born, or when Jesus was born, and Mary took Jesus and she wrapped him in that swaddling. And that was the only thing that he had. And I think about when we bring diapers in, and those moms wrap those babies in those diapers, and how years later Jesus would say, what you have done for the least of these, you have done for me. So thank you for being a part of that and living out Jesus' mission tonight.
Thank you, Mary. It's wonderful work that they do there at the Community Hope Center. Again, we thank you for joining us this evening. It has been an absolute pleasure to present three gifts to you, and we hope it has brought peace and joy to your hearts. Before we leave tonight, we're going to do kind of a benediction in song, because we want to give all the honor and glory to God, all power and blessing, all wisdom and strength. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. And as we leave tonight, once we're done singing this, if you'll give the choir enough time to get down, they'd like to greet you before you leave. If you give them time to get out of the loft, the choir loft here, and towards the back, we would all love to greet you and wish you a Merry Christmas. Thank you so much for coming tonight.
Oh,
I'd like to acknowledge our narrators. The Wydras, who were Mary, Joseph, and Jesus, where are they? Are they coming out? Good. They did a wonderful job. Clark, who is up in the booth just running everything, and I think he has someone. Who else does he have with him? George? Charles. Charles and Clark up there. And Kristen, who is our director of worship arts. Without her, this couldn't have happened tonight, and we're so grateful to have her with us. Thank you so much for coming. Merry Christmas to you. Now, if you'll give us just a few moments to get down and out there, we'll be out there to greet you. Thank you so much for coming.